Hi, I'm John Stanley.
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 Yeah, sure, I know who I am.
Just imagine, less than 10 years ago, cloning was unheard of. Now there are predictions of cloning whole bodies from single cells. The Clones is a motion picture about one such occurrence, but tonight I'm putting aside the movie, and I'm going to subject you to a different kind of ordeal.
Well, you're really a chicken.
Boy, I'm telling you, you ever try to live with a gorilla?
The Gothic mansion behind me is known around these parts as the old Bates place. Why, it's enough to give a grown man night. Hey, wait a minute, I know you. I've seen you before.
Hello, Mr. Stanley.
Norman? Is that you?
Welcome to the Bates place. We're very pleased you've come. We'd love to have you up to the house for dinner. You see, Mother is receiving visitors again.
Today we're at 20th Century Fox in Beverly Hills, and this is the home of Star Wars. It all started here 4 years ago in the imagination of George Lucas. This is the key to room number one of the Bates Motel. 23 years ago, American moviegoers were shocked when Janet Leigh was suddenly, viciously murdered in the shower stall of room number one. In Alfred Hitchcock's 1960 classic, Psycho, moviegoing and storytelling were never quite the same after that. Now in 1983, 750 creature feature fans have gathered here at the Regency Theater in San Francisco to relive the terror of Norman Bates in Psycho 2.
The legacy of Doug McClure, the joys and the sorrows. Later tonight on Creature Features, that's going to be our subject as Doug lets his hair down a little and explains how he overcame some of his problems, including alcoholism. And what made you decide to quit?
Well, I'm a recovering alcoholic, and I realized that. And I've been denying it for so long, and I realized that I had to go in the hospital and take care of it. And thank God I did.
Freeze. Hold it right there. Hold it. Keep your hands high.
Hey, Shaft!
No. Come out of there.
Richard Roundtree.
Right, say it again.
Richard Roundtree. Right.
I'm Barnaby Jones, and I am presently working with the San Francisco Bunko Squad, and you are under arrest.
Under arrest? What for?
For impersonating a TV host. Now get him up. Against the wall.
Oh, you know how to do it. You've been arrested before.
Would you find yourself capable of going in a time machine back to the 1930s and assassinating a political figure like Hitler?
I personally could not do it. I don't want to think I can do it, kill anybody.
Oh, there you are. How come you're late? I've been waiting for you.
Why is this man helping Creature Features host John Stanley aboard this hearse? Whose mummy is this? And why will she follow John Stanley to the bitter ends of the world? And will John Stanley stand the test of the ordeal of weapons? Tune in and hear John say...
I don't like your attitude, Taylor.
I know, I get a lot of complaints about it.
John Stanley's wacky world of Creature Features.
See John Stanley strangled by a killer corncob fiend in Attack of the Incredible Killer Scarecrow. Saturday, February 12th at 11:30 on the Channel 2 Creature Feature.
Casablanca, land of intrigue and mystery, haven for misfits and refugees from justice. In John Stanley's new mini-movie, Return to Casablanca. The Casablanca, hotbed of international spies, where danger awaits the intruder, and Devil's Island is the destination of the losers. Dangerous, exotic women who will stop at nothing to fulfill their desires. See John Stanley in Return to Casablanca, Creature Features.
Now, if any one thing stands out in my mind, it's the people I've associated with.
Poor little fella.
My producer. Well, Spock is dead. Are you worried about the continued existence of Captain Kirk?
Wait a minute. Who says Spock is dead? You say Spock is dead.
I saw the movie. As host of Creature Features every Saturday night here on Channel 2, I normally surround myself with zombies, werewolves, and vampires, but occasionally I prefer she-creatures of a far more intellectual nature. So meet the girls of the Hee-Haw Show. You've played some very excellent heavies. One-Eyed Jax, opposite Marlon Brando, The Hanging Tree, Nevada Smith.
But John, you know, what? To me, there's no such thing as a heavy. There's no man who gets up in the morning and says, I'm going to be mean.
You happen to know where Gonzalez is hiding out?
I might. Why?
Well, Boggs is making a lot of phone calls to Stooley's. He's looking for him.
Uh-huh. So?
So I think you ought to alert Gonzalez. I think you ought to give him some
protection. There he is. There you are. Take a look. Take a look. There you are.
That's too close to the
table. They put a circle around you, too.
John gave me this. He gave me this creature feature. John Stanley's Creature Features Movie Guide. That is something everybody ought to have.
Hey, what's the idea of bringing me out here to Morningside Mortuary like this?
I wanted to entertain you in a setting in which I feel most at home. I promise you every comfort.
Well, you certainly believe in atmosphere and realistic settings. This graveyard is just like a scene out of Phantasm. A critic once wrote that despite the fact you were the author of some of the most terrifying suspense and horror novels ever written, you still have the heart of a small child. Is that right?
Well, just want to show you my heart's in the right place.
Heroes were created by the god of adventure, and we, the spectators, were intended to cheer them to new victories. Heroes are men and women sworn to excitement, citizens of a gallant kingdom. Heroes are doers of deeds larger than life, performing on the stages of our imagined spectacles. Heroes are derring-do incarnate, writing to us out of the fog of action, out of the mist of bold bravado. Heroes were meant to be, and we, spectators to their noble deeds, to dream of them as immortal, unstoppable, incapable of feet of clay. Heroes are life exaggerated. Heroes cannot, should not, must never be touched by the specter of death. And yet, can it be that in some lost, cold, dark nebula of space, where no hero has dared go before, that the fingers of death have touched one of our most exalted heroes? If it is so, then the blackness of space night is falling darker around us. Spock is dead. His body poisoned by Gamma and Omega. His new dead corpse lies on Genesis, newborn planet. It cannot be. It must not be, for heroes are created by the god of adventure to live, not to die. Now that the show is over, would someone please get me out of these chains?
Come to me.
Don't want no one.